take a moment here, and I'm going to call an audible this morning, that I had my mind messed up and wasn't thinking properly, and I did not change our confession and forgiveness into the program today. So rather than Thanksgiving for baptism, we will do the confession and forgiveness. It's just, it's found on page 117 instead of 119. So I think we can handle it. That kind of a, just one page back and you'll be fine.
Oh, I got to turn my mic on too a bit.
Is that better, sir? There we go.
He's yelling at you.
It's me. It was me all along. Anyway, it was me. So that all being said, then let's rise as we are able and we'll begin worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought or in deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Thus renew us and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. Our opening hymn is number 677. The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit to be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
the peace from above and for our salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Jesus Christ, most merciful Redeemer, for the countless blessings and benefits you give. May we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day, praising you with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading today comes from 1 Samuel, the third chapter. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out. And Samuel was laying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of the God was. When the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel," and he said, "Here I am." And he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, I did not call my son. Lie down again. Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again, a third time. And he got up and went to Eli and said, Here I am, for you called me. Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, Samuel, Samuel. And Samuel said, Speak, for your servant is listening. Then the Lord said to Samuel, See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make both the ears of anyone who hears it tingle. On that day, I will fulfill against Eli all I have spoken concerning his house from the beginning to end. For I have told him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew because his sons were blaspheming God and he did not restrain them. Therefore, I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be expiated by a sacrifice or offering forever. Samuel lay there until morning. Then he opened the door of the house of the Lord. Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli. But Eli called Samuel and said, Samuel, my son. He said, Here I am, Eli said. What is it that he told you? Do not hide it from me. May God do so to you and more also, if you hide anything from me of all that he told you. So Samuel told him everything and hid nothing from him. Then he said, It is the Lord, let him do what seems good to him. As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel from Dan to Beersheba knew that Samuel was a trustworthy prophet of the Lord.
The psalm refrain for today, January 17th, goes as follows. You have searched me out and known me. Let's sing that together.
You have searched me out and known me.
Lord, you have searched me out. O Lord, you have known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thoughts from afar. You trace my journeys and my resting places and are acquainted with all my ways. Indeed, there is not a word on my lips, but you, O Lord, know it all together. You have searched me out and known me. You encompass me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain to it. For you yourself created my inmost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I will thank you because I am marvelously made. Your works are wonderful, and I know it well. You have searched me out and known me. My body was not hidden from you while I was being made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my limbs,
yet unfinished in the womb. All of them were written in your book. My days were fashioned before they came to be. How deep I find your thoughts, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I were to count them, they would be more in number than the sand. To count them all, my lifespan would need to be like yours. You have searched me out and known me.
The second reading today comes from 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter. All things are lawful for me, but not all things are beneficial. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food. And God will destroy both one and the other. The body is meant not for fortification, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And the Lord raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? Should I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that whoever is united with a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it is said, the two shall be one flesh. But anyone united to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Shun fornication, every sin that a person commits outside the body. But for the fornicator, sin against the body itself. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. Here ends the reading.
Alleluia!
Gospel according to St. John, the 1st chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph, from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Let us pray. Good and gracious God, you found us among the darkness and led us into the light and life of our Savior Jesus. Let us quiet our hearts and minds as we learn more of your way, that we might share your peace and love with the people yearning to know that they are known and cared for. May our presence reflect your grace and mercy as we go about our daily business, finding those who are seeking a way to deal with the pressures of everyday life and the struggles we face during this time of pandemic. Abide in us that we may abide in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My dear friends in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord Jesus. Amen. Big Joe had one last story to share at deer camp. He was in the woods most of the day, and as night approached, a hunter walked up to him. This hunter was visibly upset. His coat was wide open, his breathing was kind of heavy, and a bit of a wild look was on his face. "I'm glad I found you," he exclaimed when he came up to Joe. Big Joe politely asked how things were going. The reply was frantic. You see, this hunter explained that he was lost. He had told him where this camp was at, and asked Big Joe if he knew of it. Well, Joe did recognize where he had come from and where the man was talking about, and he went ahead and informed him that, sure, that the road he needed wasn't very far off, just a quick walk away, and he would be back at his camp in no time. So Big Joe bid this man good luck, and he began to walk away, heading toward his vehicle. When the hunter pointed his rifle at Big Joe and demanded that Joe lead him back to his camp, well, that kind of changed things. Pardon me. It was well past dark when Big Joe finally made it back to the car and the rest of his hunting party. He shared what had happened, visibly shaken himself. That was the last time Big Joe ever stepped into the woods. You know, there are many ways and meanings to that term, lost. You know, when we misplace something, or we might say, it's lost. Rather than, right, I can't remember where I put it. When things get a little crazy, we might declare that we have lost our mind. There are stories that are lost forever to history. Or it's possible to lose our way amid all the stuff that happens in this world. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. That's how our first lesson opens today. The word of the Lord seems lost. The priesthood had taken to worshiping other gods. They had taken advantage of the people they were there to lead. And God was about to punish them. The Lord then found the young Samuel. And he spoke to him. He delivered words for Samuel to declare, and Samuel did so. Things get lost, but then are found. The psalmist reminds us that the Lord searches us out. He knows us and has known us from the very beginning, which is reflected in our hearing of the gospel also this day. Jesus goes to Galilee and finds Philip. Philip is then said to have found Nathanael and tells him that they, Philip, Andrew, and Peter, have found Jesus, son of Joseph of Nazareth, the one who the law and prophets spoke of. What I find most interesting is that Jesus indeed finds us first. It wasn't that Philip and Andrew and Peter found Jesus. Jesus had already found them. You know, it's that he sees us before we ever really see him. Jesus is intentional in finding us and seeing us for who we are. Those that are lost and in need of his saving grace are seen. We need to see Jesus in our lives and point the way for others to see Jesus also. When we look to Jesus, we see the goodness and mercy, kindness and justice found in him. We look to Jesus, not like we would as if we were shopping for new clothes or a car or whatever else we might think we need to purchase. Measuring all the pros and cons of seeing him, of taking him in. Rather, we just see him. And in him, we see the way to a right relationship with God. When we are found, we see that we live in the light of Christ. When we are found, we will see things beyond our imaginations. We will see that love wins, that hatred can be replaced by unity. When we are found, we see Jesus as the way to abundant life, life for all of creation. Amen.
If you lead me.
I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send?
With the whole church, let us confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Guided by Christ made known to the nations, let us offer our prayers for the church, for our bishops, Elizabeth and Catherine, for the world and all people in need.
For the body of Christ gathered throughout the world and for all the servants of the gospel that follow Jesus, the church lives out its calling every day. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For the well-being of creation, for plants and animals, and for all that God has marvelously made, that we may serve as wise stewards of the earth, our home, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For police officers and firefighters, for attorneys and paralegals, for peacekeepers and military personnel, and for the leaders of governments, that they provide protection to all people, especially the most vulnerable. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For those lacking food or shelter, for those who are sick or grieving, and for those who are imprisoned or homebound, we especially at this time pray for all the members of our congregation, our friends, and our families, and any we would like to name out loud or in our hearts at this time. That God console all who suffer, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For our neighborhood, for visitors joining us for the first time or returning, and for those absent from our assembly, that all who seek to know God are nourished by word and sacrament, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
In thanksgiving for the saints who have gone before us, that their lives give us a vision of the gospel in action, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God. Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
May the peace of Christ be with you always. Share the peace somehow. Peace, great. Peace, everyone. I like that. That's a good one back there. It's almost like jazzy hands.
There needs to be a swing choir.
There we go. God of all goodness, generations have turned to you, gathered around your table, and shared your abundant blessings. Number us among them, that as we gather these gifts from your abundance and give thanks for your rich blessings, we may feast upon your very self and care for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Be holy, holy Lord, God of power.
Mighty and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. And great love you sent to us, Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, all of you. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace.
The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you.
Eat, for now the feast is spread.
Come, let us eat, for now the feast is spread.
Our Lord's body let us take together.
Our Lord's body let us take together.
Come, let us drink, for now the wine is poured.
Come, let us drink, for
of our Lord we gather.
In the presence of our Lord we gather.
Rise then to spread abroad God's mighty word.
Rise then to spread abroad God's mighty word.
Jesus risen will bring in the kingdom.
Jesus risen will bring in the kingdom.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people, Israel.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this simple meal you have set a banquet. Sustain us on the journey. Strengthen us to care for the least of your beloved children, and give us glad and generous hearts as we meet you on the way. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. volunteers for our Synod Assembly this year. That's going to be entirely online. It's an entire week. When it opens on a Monday with a worship service in the evening, and then during the week there will be workshops that you can attend via Zoom. You don't have to go to them, but they'll be there available. Friday evening there will be a worship, and then Saturday will be the actual business day where we have to vote on new council members and stuff like that. So consider that, and there will be great discussion about the document of discovery and whether or not we're going to approve that and sign that. And that's something, there's all sorts of information on the website about the document of discovery. You might want to, whether you're going to be a representative or not, you'll probably, it's a good read, I think. It's certainly opened my eyes to a few things that I wasn't aware of. I guess the other thing was, I saw a link the other day that you might want to pull up to if you have computer access, from the Washington, D.C. Synod, where on the 6th, when all that craziness was happening, the church there in Washington, D.C., the one that our president had pushed people out of earlier in the year so that he could stand there and take a picture with the Bible in his hand, well, the protesters had broken into that church and reenacted the George Floyd killing, while the bishops of the area and whatnot were in there praying for peace and healing and wholeness. And if you want to hear that bishop's response to that tragedy, you can go to the DC Metro website, dcmetrosynod.org, wasn't it, Bobby? I think I said
it. I don't remember, but yeah.
It was a very compelling speech that she gave. If you want it and you can't find it that way, let me know. I'll get you the right link. I've got it somewhere in for South Plainview. But anyway, any other announcements? We going to change the time so that I can try to beat the clock tomorrow? Or
10:15.
10:15 for our council meeting. Sounds good. Anything else then? If not, go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thank you, God.